It is a huge story across the country. It is a big story right here in New York City, as well as one local advocate asked Mayor Bill de Blasio about expanding those specialized schools. Take a listen.
Why are there not more specialized high schools? Why are they not blowing up in this neighborhood? York High School only has 100 kids per grade. Why not 1,000?
I think the current admissions process is imbalanced. We need to start over and have a conversation about what would be a fairer admission system than the one we have now. And then I think that is also the right time to talk about how to either expand existing specialized high schools or add some new ones.
Unbelievable. So don't add more kids. Let's just change the whole thing and keep the seats. I mean, it's insane. Joining us now, that local advocate herself, Frances Kweller, Kweller Prep director and founder. She's very positive in the midst of the story. Let me set the scene here in New York, though, because I want to give people out there some stats that are different from Seattle. So Stuyvesant, for example, is the number one ranked specialized high school in the state, might be in the country. It's a single test that gets you in. That's what Mayor de Blasio was talking about. 82% of the students are minority. You can see there, 74% of them are Asian. 45% are on public assistance, government help. 80%, by the school's own reporting and their own paper, are first-generation Americans, or their parents are. This isn't diversity. I mean, they're not white. They are from low-income families, and they're immigrants. But that still isn't diverse enough for Mayor de Blasio. What do you think about that, Frances? He wants to get rid of that test that gets people in and take people into the school in a different way. Should we get rid of the test in New York?
The issue is not about the test. The issue is what the test reveals. There's a real disparity in K-8 education across the board. And to note, with the way the gifted and talented programs work, there is not one citywide gifted and talented program in the Bronx right now. The gifted and talented, there's just not enough of it. My question was not fully answered when I spoke with the mayor. And that was a comment that I feel very passionately about. The issue is the core education and access. When you have a young child, I'm a mother with young children right now, and to have not even one school that offers this kind of citywide GNT opportunity in my entire borough, I mean, there are only so many hours in the day. How can you possibly even contemplate saying, well, it's the issue is the test in eighth grade?
And Frances, I mean, your parents are immigrants. You came to this country and you advocate for students and help students in the public school system. You know, what they would point to is that at Stuyvesant, for example, where, I mean, this is an impossible school to get into. And the kids, you know, they say when you talk to kids that graduate from there, it means more to say you went to Stuyvesant High School than it means to say you went to Harvard University, because it's harder to get into Stuyvesant. What they would point out, that 3% of the student body is Hispanic and only 1% is African American. Mayor de Blasio's answer to that was to instead say that the top kids from Brooklyn or from the Bronx or from these from schools that are predominantly African American, if you took the top 10% of those kids or whatever it is, and they automatically got into Stuyvesant, even if they didn't score high enough on the test, that's one of the solutions that's being proposed. Would that work in your opinion? Could they do the work when they got there? Did they get a good enough education in their middle schools?
Absolutely not. There are some middle schools where 90% of the student body is performing below grade level. How can they possibly excel just by being placed into a school with that type of rigor and competitiveness? The real issue that should be addressed is the K-8 education and the systemic issues with access to that type of education. It is not equal when certain neighborhoods and certain boroughs do not have students, or middle schools that even offer basic regions in eighth grade. It's just not fair. And it starts way before the SHSCT.
Yeah, I mean, did anyone make that point to the mayor? Because that's really it. It's not that one group of people is smarter than another group of people, or that one neighborhood is better than another. It's this idea that they're not getting the support in the lower grades to get to eighth grade and be able to do really well on this test. You got to focus on the education in the middle schools to get everybody up to a better standard. You know, did anyone ask that? Does he have an answer?
My question, which it was asking specifically about, why does York, the only specialized high school in Queens, have 100 seats, 1,000 want to get in, 30,000 take the test. It really just wasn't answered. And the K-8, it wasn't addressed.
No, the K-8 or to add more seats, as you said, is the other solution. Then you could bring in those kids and then not penalize the kids who do well on the test as well. I don't know. I mean, it's a tough problem, but penalizing the kids that are doing well doesn't make sense, especially when they meet this diversity criteria anyway, when you look at socioeconomic factors, immigration, all that. Frances, thank you for coming on. We appreciate your time. Mm-hmm.